Two leading photo enlargers tested on three high-resolution images. Which one will produce the best image quality? That's today's challenge. Today I'm putting Topaz Gigapixel AI 6 and On1 Resize AI to the test. I want to test which one of these will produce the best quality enlargements. To test these two photo enlargers, I've chosen three sample images. In this testing, I'm not interested in speed, special features or anything else. I just want to compare the quality of the enlarged image to see visually which I prefer. The first image we'll be testing is this landscape. I shot it as a RAW file using the Fuji X-T3 with a Fuji 10-24 lens. It was then converted to an image using DxO Photolab. If you want to know my workflow in Photolab, I'll include a link in the YouTube description to a video where I explain it. After opening the image in Topaz Gigapixel AI, I have a choice of AI models I can use for the enlargement. Which one is best depends on what's in the image that I'm enlarging. For this test, I'll leave the model set to the standard image as we'll be working with a high resolution landscape. There's then a choice of settings which I can use to suppress image noise and remove any blur as part of the enlargement. Above these is a switch to allow the software to analyse the image and automatically set the value of these sliders. I'll just accept the default to see how well the software does. What is important though is the output width and resolution that I want to produce. The original image from this camera is around 21 inches by 14 inches at 300 dpi. I'm going to increase this to produce a 60 inch image at 300 dpi, which is around a 300% increase. Now let's do the same thing as near as possible using On1 Resize AI. With the image open in the software, you can see the current size and resolution. I'll set this to produce a 60 inch image on the long edge to match the gigapixel enlargement. As with Gigapixel, Resize AI has a choice of resizing methods in the settings section. You can choose from two AI methods and you'll also find two legacy methods in the dropdown. After looking into the AI methods, I understand the faithful method applies slightly less noise reduction and sharpening. I'll therefore use the standard method in this head-to-head challenge. Unlike with Gigapixel, there doesn't seem to be any control over the noise reduction and sharpening applied during the enlargement, and it seems to be taken care of by the algorithm. There is an option to apply additional sharpening, but I think this is additional post-enlargement, so I'll try without this at the moment. Now you understand what I've done, let's compare the results of this first test. I've opened both images side by side in Photoshop with the view set to 100% magnification to compare them. In this first area taken from the rocks in the foreground, the On1 results appear to be a little sharper and more detailed than Gigapixel. But there is something that looks slightly synthetic about the On1 results. Now let's look at the photographer in the distance. He looks slightly better defined in the Gigapixel version than the On1 enlargement, but there isn't much in it. But something I have noticed while checking these results is that Gigapixel has made a better enlargement of the sky. In the On1 enlargement, I can see the clouds appear to have been over-sharpened. I can also see a faint pattern in some of the areas which isn't present in the Gigapixel enlargement. On these results, I would say that Gigapixel produced a better result because of the over-sharpening and faint artifacts I'm seeing in the On1 enlargement. We'll be coming back to this later because I need to share some findings with you. First though, let's look at enlarging the second example image. This is an image that I downloaded from a stock library and I don't have the camera data because it's been stripped out. What I can tell you though is that loading it in On1, it produces an 18x12 image at 300 dpi. As before, I'll enlarge this to a 60 inch image on the long edge, which is slightly over a 300% increase. This time though, I'm going to change the enlargement method to Faithful AI to see if it produces the pattern I was seeing with the previous enlargement. Now with the image in Gigapixel, I'll set the output width to 60 inches. I'll use the standard AI model for the enlargement, and I'll leave the settings section switched to auto so the software chooses the noise and blur reduction levels to apply. Now let's compare the results side by side in Photoshop. If we look at the first comparison of the woman's face, the Gigapixel version on the right appears sharper. But I would say this time the image looks too sharp and the skin texture seems to be overemphasized. The On1 version in comparison appears slightly softer and to my mind looks more natural. I'll accept that it would be possible to improve the results from both packages using their additional features, but that's not the idea of this test. This test is to see how they perform in default mode given that both are AI software. Now let's look at a second area of the image to compare the hair. Again, Topaz Gigapixel has produced amazingly sharp detail, but to my mind, it looks too sharp and synthetic. In contrast, On1 Resize AI appears more natural. The final area that I want to compare in this image is the out of focus background. With the On1 image, you can see the hair in this area remains more natural, but the background has retained a slight texture. In the Gigapixel version, the hair looks overly sharp, but the texture is gone. Personally, I'd like to see the faint texture rather than the super smooth look of the out of focus area. With this image, I would say that On1 wins out based on more natural looking results. Reassuringly, what I can't see in the On1 enlargement is the strange grid pattern that I saw with the first image. Perhaps switching to the faithful AI method is producing a better result. So let's put that to the test with a third example and go back to another landscape. This time it's an image I shot using a Panasonic G9 Micro Four Thirds camera. It's a RAW capture which I then processed using DxO Photo Lab. This produced a 17 by 13 inch image at 300 dpi. As before, I'll set the output size on the On1 Resize to 60 inches at 300 dpi and I'll continue using the faithful AI resizing method. With the same image in Topaz Gigapixel, I'll also set the output to 60 inches wide at 300 dpi. As before, I'll continue using the standard AI model and I'll leave the noise suppression and blur removal set to auto levels determined by the software. After processing the images, let's compare the results side by side at 100% magnification. In this first section from the foreground rock, the On1 sample on the left appears far too sharp, whilst the Gigapixel result looks softer and more natural. This overly sharp appearance from the On1 enlargement has happened despite using the faithful AI enlargement method. When I look around the image, there are a lot of areas where the detail appears just too sharp, and if I look very closely, there seems to be a kind of mesh pattern that's emphasizing the detail. You may be able to see this in a second comparison taken from the cliffs at the back of the frame. Now I did discover that I can reduce the oversharpening using the smoothness slider, but it didn't remove the pattern entirely. So let's talk a minute about what seems to be happening before I pick a winner. After carrying out some more tests, I found that On1 seems to generate a mesh pattern on some areas, but not all images. It also restricts the pattern to areas where you might expect to see lots of detail, but it can spill over into clouds and other areas where you don't want it. The images from my Micro Four Thirds camera seem to be particularly susceptible to this problem. But look at this image taken with a Canon 5D Mark II full frame camera from 2011. When I enlarge this image to 60 inches wide, I don't see the mesh pattern in the On1 enlargement, although the detail still appears slightly too sharp. This mesh pattern that I'm seeing may be a way that the software is trying to create the appearance of detail in the enlargement, but it may also be due to something else. I have another theory about what could be causing the mesh pattern. If you're interested, there's a link in the video description to an article I published a while back about this. Now to the winner of the challenge, and I want to say that I'm really impressed by both of these packages. The 60 inch images I produced in this video are all excellent. I would happily use either of these two products in my workflow if I wanted to produce an enlargement. Remember, I haven't tried to maximize image quality here with the additional software features, but today the winner from my testing is Topaz Gigapixel. It produced great results with all of the images I tested, and there are no obvious problems in any of the enlargements. On1 Resize AI came a very close second, and I did prefer it for the enlargement of the portrait. It was the overly sharp appearance in the landscape images that really let it down. Now if you like today's software challenge, you'll probably find this video interesting as well. In it I compare On1 No Noise AI with DxO's Deep Prime Noise Reduction. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and thanks for watching. I'll see you soon for another video.